Okay, let's start with the simulation of analog experiment using the circuit maker simulation package. So first experiment is a Schmitt trigger using op amp. So what we need generally, this is a circuit maker package which having the this is on the left one is the component window, and this the white space is for placement window, and file menu bar, file, edit, view options, macro, simulation, wave and help. So our more frequently we are going to use work with the menu bar file and simulation. Okay. We'll come to the which are the components with the different categories made it. That is with general. In general, we are going to use instrument, resistor, and sources, and even for one experiment that is for relaxation experiment, capacitor. And op amp is chosen from the category op amp with the fine number of pins. Okay. Well, first let's start with the first experiment, that is Schmitt trigger. So first work is to place the components, all components required. That is first start with the op amp. So first place the op amp, then place the signal generator. It's here in instrument, in general, instrument, signal generator, place it, and place the VCC and V, that is in general, source plus V. Then choose same thing to rotate this towards upward. You can use mouse right click button to rotate, and you can place bottom of it. Then now resistor place to again same thing, but to rotate this one also you can use mouse right click button. Okay, now keeping placing all the components. Now next where work is to connect these all with the help of wire. For that you can use wire tool from the but various buttons are there here. You can use wire tool from here, or you can right click in the white space. So you get various tools. So you can use you can switch between wire tool and arrow tool also. So more we are going to use wire tool more to connect it. So click on wire tool, then you can connect from one point of the any device to another device. So make sure that the connection is done with the rectangular box. You can observe the red color rectangular box. If you move the wire tool near to the terminals of the any device. So with the help of mouse left click button, click it first, then you can check, you can see that it's a red color rectangular box. Then drag the mouse to where you want to next point where you want to connect it. So here I connected to in inverting terminal of the op amp, then reaching to that one more rectangular box you'll get, then leave the mouse left click button, so it will create the connection. Similarly, we can make connection from VCC, then minus V, then phone to resistor R1, then resistor R1 to R1, then non-inverting to the in between R1 and R2 connection. Then now you need the ground connections. Again, same thing, go to source, then choose ground, then click on place it at proper wherever you require it. Okay, again you can connect with the help of wire tool. Okay, after making all connections, again switch back to from wire tool to arrow tool. So reason for that, because we need to change the values of each component, so which are using in your resistor, where in connected components like resistor, then power supply voltage, signal generator voltage, then the type of which type of model you want to use for op amp. Then first to choose the model of op amp, double click on this op amp, it appear a list of different models. To get the required op amp 741, so on keyboard type only U. So directly reach to UA741, then click on select, then exit. Now similarly we can change the VCC value, double click, change this to plus 12 volt. Similarly, minus VE changes to minus 12 volt. Keep in mind that you have to use the minus symbol for negative voltages. Okay. Then resistor value R1, which is 15 kilo ohm. R2, which is 10 kilo ohm. And now remaining is the signal generator. So double click on signal generator. So only to change only peak amplitude, nothing else, no need to change any other things. Only change the peak amplitude, change to 10 volt and click OK. Now after making proper connection, save this file. So wherever you want, you can save this one and give the name as 1B simulation. All right, simu. Okay, then click save. After saving this, make sure that all things are connected properly, all values of resistors are correct, supply voltages also are correct, signal generator voltage also correct. Now we need to run it. So for run that one, go to simulation menu bar, click on run. So your mouse cursor change to the from arrow tool to the probe tool. Probe tool basically used to check the waveform from which line, whether it is input line or output line or any other line also. Now you can observe that the black color window is get appeared, that is transient analysis, nothing but your CRO screen. To get input waveform, click at the input side. Probe tool were pointing it, you can observe that one. It will appear A. When you click in A, you will get sine wave in green color. Similarly, we can click on output also, will get the rectangular waveform in green color. Now two waveform to simultaneously you want to observe it. So first press the shift key of your keyboard, then click the second waveform you want to observe, that is your input waveform, click here. So you can in yellow color input waveform will appearing, and in green color output waveform happen. Color may get interchange. You can make input also green color or output yellow color also. To note down this one, increase the size of this one waveform window, and you can note down the UTP value with the cross section of rectangular waveform and sine wave. This is exactly as it is, a cross section at plus 5 volt. Similarly, UTP, which is minus 5 volt, and plus VSAT is plus 10 volt, and minus VSAT is minus 10 volt. Similar experiment, these are the readings that note down it. And after note down, to stop this simulation, again go to menu bar simulation and click on stop. It will stop the simulation. And similarly, we can take down the readings for any other set of values, like change in the VCC, VE, and you can change the value of R1 and R2. So you can repeat the same thing for any other setup. Different setup values. You can try it with different setup values, like VCC is 15 volt, minus V is minus 15 volt, and if UTP is 4 volt and LTP is minus 4 volt, then based on that you calculate the value of R1 and R2. Okay. Thank you.